Hello and welcome back to the training. So in this video, what I will walk you through is how you can go about finding the relevant pages that we'll go ahead and start extracting emails from so we can start our outreach campaigns. So the very first thing you're going to need is you're going to need a extension or a premium tool within Scrapebox. So once you've downloaded Scrapebox, you will want to add on or buy the premium plugin that's called the Email Scraper Premium. If you go to the Scrapebox website, you can actually buy them all as a bundle for, I believe, $147. So if you like a lot of the tool sets and you don't want just one, this single tool, I believe, is like $50. If you want them all, it's $150. So I think I bought a medium package where I got these ones here. In any case, what you'll do is you'll go ahead and just click on this. A new tool will emerge, which is going to be the premium email scraper. So the next piece that we will want to do is, once we already know our niche, of course, which for this tutorial is going to be lawyers. I really want to reach out to lawyers. So a very well-known site here in the United States for lawyers is called Avo. On Avo, you know, it's almost like a directory for lawyers. So I would assume that Avo is considered an authority source. So a lot of lawyers or lawyer sites that are related are going to link out to Avo or their profiles. I'm sure I could pick up some lawyers or lawyer affiliated sites in the link graph from Avo. So that's exactly what I'm going to use. So what I like to do is I'll come over here to the link building tab inside of SEMrush. I'll be using SEMrush for this tutorial. On the left hand side here, you'll go to backlink analytics. We'll click on that. For this example, again, I typed in Avo. Okay, I did a brief search. Once I did the search for Avo, we'll go to referring domains. It's right here. Click referring domains. Once inside of referring domains, we could see that there's 61,000 referring domains coming to this website. But we want to trim this list up a little bit. So what you want to do is we want to go ahead and sort generally from 25 to 100. If you want more potent links, that's fine. But I want a nice variety, but not in the lower ranges. You know, to hit an authority score of 25 takes a little bit of time. It's not super powerful, but it's not ultra weak. But so 25 to 100 is what I do for this, at least. Once we do that, we also want to add one more thing on top of that, which is going to be an advanced filter. So you click on advanced filters. And then this button right here, we'll go to exclude. And then we're going to exclude particular TLDs. And the two that I like to do, or the three, is going to be .edu, all right, and education. So there's two and one. And then the next one, the last one, is the .government, okay? So just because the probability of getting, you know, a link placement on a .gov or an .edu or an education site is significantly lower than a regular website. So what we now have is our list, 15,085 referring domains, all pointing at Avo. So they're in the link graph for sure, at least for lawyers. So what we're going to do now is we will export this list, and I actually already have. And what I do is I go out to my Google Chrome browser. If you're using Chrome, you already have this tool, which is called Sheets. It's Google Sheets. So up in the top right hand corner, if you click on the nine dots and then click on Drive, what's really great about this is you can take the download file that goes to your download bar here, and you can literally drag and drop it right into your folder, and it'll just open up for you. So I guess we could do that together, even though I already have done it. We'll just go to Replace Existing. All right, and I'll just start this back over. We'll do it again together. What I'll do here is I'm going to clean this out because I'm only concerned with the domains. I already know that they meet my authority requirement. So we'll click this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Get rid of these. Delete selected rows. And then the score I'm not overly concerned with. And then we're going to go ahead and just move this out so we could take a look. I'll remove this. And then generally I just go down the list, and if it's something that pops out at me, if it's not such a large list, this is pretty big, like these down here. I remember those. We'll go ahead and just clean those off of here because I don't really have use for these types of sites. All right. So we have 15,095 potential prospects. So this is looking pretty good. Now, the issue with these exports, at least a semi-issue, is it doesn't append the HTTPS. Now, I'm not proficient enough in Excel or Sheets to be able to add it. So what I do is I just head out here to this tool here, pinetools.com/add text each line. I just went ahead and pasted the list inside of here. I checked this button, add text at the beginning of the lines, http://, and then bada bing, bada boom, it added all of that text for me. So now I actually have a list of the referring domains that's usable within Scrapebox. Now, within Scrapebox, what are we going to do with this? The first thing is we have to save it to a text file. So that's what we'll do right now. So we'll go ahead and add this, Control V. So we'll paste that on there. File, save as, I'll put it to the desktop, and I will name this lead list for email scrape, just so I can go ahead and start that off. We'll go to save. Okay. So now we have our list. I'll close this. Can get rid of this, get rid of this. All right. And now we have our list that will be ready to use inside of the Scrapebox Premium email scraping tool. So I'll look forward to seeing you in the next training, where we will start working inside of the tool. I'll see you there.